How's it going, guys? Garrick here again. This video, I'm taking you guys to the island of Lanai, where we go hunt some axis deer. It's one of my favorite hunts every year. I look forward to it every year. This year, we got a little bit of screwed up with COVID, and a lot of the seasons got messed up, but luckily, we got in right at the very last minute for muzzleloader season. We also did a little bit of paid hunts on the island of Lanai. On the company side, so we got a mix and match of a lot of different hunts in this video, and I hope you guys enjoy. Chee-hoo! All right, aloha, guys. First things first, we get to the gun range, and I give these guys a muzzleloader class. On this trip, Nick and Lawrence have never shot a muzzleloader before. They get used to loading it, shooting it, cleaning it, and we get the other shotgun that we'll be using for the hunt dialed in. We spend the rest of the afternoon driving around, sightseeing, and scouting all the areas that we would be hunting in the next up and coming days. Between trying to get these guys on some deer and trying to harvest one myself, I was trying to take some videos and some photos of some of the deer that we were seeing. Some were some really good deer with no shot opportunities. And some of the deer that I had videos of, my buddies would have been more than willing to harvest, but just not quite what I was looking for. But unfortunately, when these shot opportunities arise, they're not with me. I'd like to introduce you to Justin Lanis, good friend and fellow hunter, and sometimes part-time comedian. He had never hunted with a muzzleloader, so I invited him on this hunt. We spot a nice buck bedded down underneath some trees, and the stalk was on. We stalked in, got into position, got set up, and we were waiting for the buck to give us a good shot opportunity. He was bedded down and there was a little hill that was blocking his vitals. In the meantime, I was trying to crawl in to get a better angle to video the shot. And the wait began. After crawling in a little closer, I tried getting Justin's attention to let him know to give me the heads up when he was gonna fire, but I don't know if he heard me or not. I was trying to catch the shot on camera, but I was a second short.
Yeah, I think you see him kicking.
I think
killed my first buck with the muscle loader. I'm gonna see right now. Check it out. Yesterday we did the pay hunt and today steep hunt. What a rush. I've accomplished axis deer with the bow and axis deer with the rifle, but I've never done axis deer with the muzzleloader, so that was a different rush for me. Very different rush.
The trail on a buck.
I'm guiding right now.
Yeah.
Get blood going. Get the
blood
going.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, we gonna find this guy. 80 yards.
Take your time.
We'll see.
Quick pause. Lawrence ended up not being able to recover on his buck because although they had a pretty good blood trail to follow, the rain came in and washed everything away. Sorry, buddy. We'll get him next time.
Soaking. Oh, man.
Wet.
Yep. We in it.
I absolutely love hunting in Lanai. Ever since I was a kid, I got to hunt here. And now being able to come back and share this experience with some friends and family is one of my favorite things to do every year.
Is he the slobber?
Yeah, he is. Atta boy.
Yeah, we can put them right by the dirt as we don't want to be cleaning them. Congrats, Nick, on some of your really nice harvests in Lanai. Chee-hoo, buddy. All right. So when I wasn't guiding, I got to get behind the trigger, and I got to harvest a couple of really nice deer myself. Funny story, the buck in this first picture, I was actually trying to get Lawrence or Nick to get up on it, but they got busted, and it walked right to me. I couldn't let that shot pass. After each harvest, the work begins. Here I got a couple photos and videos of me gutting some of the deer we harvested on this trip.
That was a bullet rib fragment. Yeah. Or something, maybe the bullet.
Yeah, do you want me to lift this thing up?
Yeah, just hold our legs.
least there's no flies.
Right? That would be bad. Okay, lift his front legs right up on top of that bush.
Yeah, we ate up Chris's moose heart. It wasn't that long ago, maybe a couple months. He put it in the soup.
How was it?
It was good. It didn't taste as good as like a roast, but because it was boiled, but I could see it being like really well prepared. Is it a boy?
So usually I butcher my own meat, but out here in Lanai, we got this guy, Bob the Butcher. Let me tell you, this guy does awesome work. I had him butcher up one of my deer in the past, and from the picture, you can see the amount of work that he puts into every single deer. On this trip, Nick and Lawrence harvested some deer, and they wanted to get a couple of them butchered by Bob. So we went in and had Bob butcher a couple of the deer for them. He also does keeping and trophy care for your trophy bucks. If you're ever in Lanai and you harvest an animal and you want to get those choice cuts, take it to Bob the Butcher. This guy is legit. The rest of the deer we processed, we put in a cooler, brined in ice cold water for a few days, and then bagged them up, got them in the freezer, and divided up to everyone that was in the hunting party. Right on, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the show. If you guys did, please give me a thumbs up. Maybe a subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next video. All right. Thank you guys. Chee-hoo. Aloha.